and he would be on top of the car, holding on with his, you know, his hands like through. You'll have to wind the windows down a bit, but he'd, you know, he'd be on top of the car. Go to the pub one night, and Jake was hammered again. He started, "Oh, can you go? Can you drive my car home? I want to ride on the roof." Jake is on the roof after about 15 pints of lager, holding on for dear life. I'm at the wheel of his Ford Escort, just trying to be as careful as I can. And Jake's like this on the roof: "Go faster, go faster." Go past the police car, please pull us in. And I'm thinking, oh no, what the hell, how am I going to explain this to my parents? Again, he had this obsession with walking into a pub and ordering 100 pints. We got to this bar, and it was in the University of Sussex, the East Slope Bar, so we got there just as it opened, and there was no one else in there. And Jake walks up to the bar and orders 100 pints of Foster's. You've never seen anything like it. It took about 20 minutes to pour all these pints. Literally, people carrying them back to the tables on trays in shifts. Literally, tables and tables and tables and tables just full of pints. I'm just trying to think how much they used to charge. This would have been in about 1989. A pint of lager in a student union bar would have been about, I gotta figure, 75 quid in my head. So maybe it was about 75p a pint. Yeah, actually, I think it's coming back to me now. We were on our way home, and one of the guys, Andy Moody, his name was, he used to live in the Hall of Residence. One arm